Many people consider Phil Jackson, a coach that has 11 NBA championships, as the best coach of all time. He won 5 championships with the Lakers, 6 championships with the Bulls. The Lakers started this season after having a crazy offseason, bringing in Steve Nash, bringing in Dwight Howard. Everybody in LA, there was so excitement. They were pulling out the playoff flags on cars in preseason. Didn't help the Lakers in preseason. They didn't win one game. When the real season started, they were 1-4. Coach Mike Brown, a very nice guy, very cool, just couldn't cut it, got the axe. The Lakers on Saturday, the executives, they went to Playa del Rey, to the home of Phil Jackson. Phil says he's been working all summer on his physical condition. He goes to a private training facility. He's in great condition. He was happy to hear from fans. He wanted to come back. He says he saw the potential in the team. They met Phil for an hour and a half at his house on Saturday. He says he got the impression that he was getting the job, that he was the man, that they would let him know by Monday about it. And he was very confident. He was excited. Phil Jackson says he did not put in any crazy demands. He did not say that he can't go on road games. He feels that that's just to save face, to make him look bad in the media. But he did not do any of that. He really wanted to coach the team. Instead, the Lakers went with Mike D'Antoni, a guy that never won a championship in the NBA, but he knows his basketball. Me, as a kid in Israel, I used to watch D'Antoni. He played for Italian teams. He used to come. He used to beat Maccabi Tel Aviv, the team from Israel. He had a mid-range jump shot. He was a very emotional player. He's very offensive-minded. He's the same way as a coach. He's great in offense. Can the Lakers now, with Steve Nash being a 38, run the same offense that Steve Nash ran when he was 32 and 31 and 33? That's the tough question here. Phil Jackson, you know what you're going to get. Respect, discipline. He's the Zen master. He has a triangle offense that no one seemed to be able to crack, but he would do it, he would make it, he knows. And Phil would get that leadway. People would give Phil Jackson a cushion before the team gets on track. Well, I don't think Mike D'Antoni will get that cushion. If Mike D'Antoni doesn't start on the right foot and he starts getting a couple losses and things don't go great right away, the demand to let him go will be high. I think people will not give him that cushion that they would give Phil Jackson. But there you have it. The players, Kobe Bryant said today that he thought that Phil Jackson will be the coach. Everybody was under that impression. But the Lakers, Sunday night at midnight, called Phil Jackson, told him, hey, we're going with D'Antoni. D'Antoni's starting. He's going to be introduced to the media in Los Angeles on Thursday. He's landing here tomorrow, Wednesday. The players, they respect D'Antoni. He's a player's coach. Kobe Bryant, growing up in Italy, looked up to D'Antoni. In fact, his first jersey in the NBA, number 8, was based on D'Antoni's number in Italy. Who is also number 8? Steve Nash likes D'Antoni. D'Antoni coached in Denver. He coached in Phoenix. He coached in New York. But there you have it. Who would you want to see coach the Lakers? Phil Jackson or Mike D'Antoni? Stay tuned. FayesNewReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback.